Believing is Real, written by J. Elizabeth. Published by WestBow Press, a division of Thomas Nelson and Zondervan. Narrated by Mike Lenz. Chapter 1. Has anyone ever said to you that he or she has heard from God? Who has really heard from God? And who knows the voice of God? As I read the Bible, I think of the major and minor prophets who all listened to what they believed was the voice of God. We know that God is a God who speaks to his people. Isaiah states, "I, even I, am the Lord, and beside me there is no Savior. I have declared and have saved, and I have shewed when there was no strange God among you. Therefore ye are my witnesses, saith the Lord, that I am God." Isaiah chapter 43, verses 11 through 12, KJV. We know that God is fully capable of speaking to his people at any time, in any way he chooses. We also know that God never changes. That means that God's nature as a God who reveals himself to people never changes. But did God always speak to his people in the same way? Did God speak to Israel in the same way as he spoke to Adam and Eve? Did God speak to the New Testament church in the same way as he spoke to Israel? In other words, does God demonstrate in his word that he speaks differently at different times? If we examine scripture, we find that God spoke to Noah 5 times over 950 years. He spoke to Abraham 8 times over 175 years. And God spoke with Isaac 2 times and with Rebekah 1 time over 180 years. He spoke to Jacob 7 times, and God spoke to Laban only 1 time over Jacob's lifetime. These are just some examples. God reveals himself to each of us in order for us to understand our purposes in life. He reveals himself so we can hear his calling on our lives. Does God speak to us concerning our personal issues and situations? Yes, he does. God not only gives us inspiration that will lead, teach, heal, and deliver his children, however, he also gives us inspiration that will encourage us when we are experiencing changes and transformations in our lives and in the lives of our families. How many people today can actually say that God has whispered a word to them, has spoken to them, or has shown them something that no one else sees and hears? How can this be? How is it that God uses the voice of people to speak to others? And how can God use others as the eyes to see through them as well? How is it that God, our Father, is the Father who bears all of our burdens as we communicate to him? And what allows God to communicate with us? I am writing about hearing the voice of God from heaven and how God reveals himself through the lives of so many people, but especially through my family. Imagine someone recognizing a special gift in you, and then that person decided to use you as the lead in a Broadway play. Or imagine someone recognizing your lovely voice and made you a great celebrity singer. What if someone realized your ability to minister and preach the Word of God? And so he or she invited you to preach internationally. Keep thinking until you have thought of someone who has made you known for something you have done or who has recognized you for your gifts and talents. Mary, the mother of Jesus, was chosen by God to carry out the will and purpose of Almighty God. I cannot even imagine the anointing that was placed upon Mary to be chosen by God to bring good news to the world. Mary found favor with God. She became a mother and had a son, and she named him Jesus. Luke chapter 1, verses 30 through 35. How would you respond if you heard the angel or the voice of God say to you that you would be the parent of the Son of the Highest, and that you are favored? What an honor it is to be chosen for a particular work or ministry that God has called only you or your family to lead or to carry out. In the book of Luke, it states, "And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shalt call his name Jesus. He shall be great, and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David, and he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. Then said Mary unto the angel, How shall this be, seeing I know not a man? And the angel answered and said unto her, The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. Therefore, also that holy thing which shall be born of thee shall be called the Son of God. Luke chapter 1, verses 30 through 35, KJV. God can use whomever or whatever he wants, whenever he wants. In the Old Testament, God used a donkey to accomplish the mission that had been set in motion. Numbers chapter 22, verses 21 through 39. Why then can't God speak through anyone at any time or in any way? Hearing his audible voice does not bring doubt to our situations, but it does bring faith to our lives. But I have heard God speak through music, other people, his word, family, dreams, my parents, and even my enemies. And it gives me hope. Who can believe the voice of the Lord? Even when we hear it, sometimes we run from the voice that we know is truly God. Have you ever heard the voice of God, but ignored this voice you clearly heard? Even when we hear the voice of God, his instructions don't always resonate with our spirits at that particular time. Rather, God's instructions could be for a set time other than now. Because we ignore and blame, or because we reason with ourselves that the voice we hear isn't real, it takes us into disobedience and not into the perfect will of God. In the book of 1 Samuel, we can see Saul's disobedience unto God. Even though God prepared the way for Saul to become king, Saul turned away from following God and did not perform God's commandments. I think one of the deepest fears is hearing what other people think and say about us. We are more concerned about the reaction of others than we are about how God will chastise us for disobedience. If God gives instructions, do we doubt God and the instructions he has given? Are we so afraid of people and what they will say or do that we do not listen to or obey the words of the Lord, even when we understand God's words and his voice? The following scriptures pertain to obeying the voice of God. And Samuel said, Hath the Lord as great delight in burnt offerings and sacrifices as in obeying the voice of the Lord? Behold, to obey is better than sacrifice, and to hearken than the fat of rams. For rebellion is as the sin of witchcraft, and stubbornness is as iniquity and idolatry. Because thou hast rejected the word of the Lord, he hath also rejected thee from being king. 1 Samuel chapter 15, verses 22 through 23, KJV. In life, we become disobedient to God and miss the blessings God had for us because we took a detour from the path in which God directed our lives. God can always restore our paths to where he wants us to go. However, it is our disobedience that derailed us for the delays, setbacks, and detours in our lives. I can think of situations I believed God was handling in the supernatural. However, I have interfered, and I became disobedient because I believed God was simply taking too long to handle them. Regardless of the timeline in which we want situations to change in our lives, God has a set time for all things to occur. Our disobedience can lead us to make situations and circumstances worse than what God had anticipated them to be. Because of his love for us, he blesses us anyhow. We can read the story in the book of Jonah, when he knew the voice of Almighty God was speaking to him with instructions. After the Lord told Jonah to go to the great city of Nineveh and preach against its wickedness, Jonah left the city and went to Tarshish, running from God. It states, Now the word of the Lord came unto Jonah, the son of Amittai, saying, Arise, go to Nineveh, that great city, and cry against it, for their wickedness is come up before me. But Jonah rose up to flee unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord, and went down to Joppa, and he found a ship going to Tarshish. So he paid the fare thereof, and went down into it, to go with them unto Tarshish from the presence of the Lord. Jonah chapter 1, verses 1 through 3, KJV. Regardless of from where we run or to where we run, the book of Psalms simplifies it for us. If I ascend up into heaven, thou art there. If I make my bed in hell, behold, thou art there. Psalm 139, verse 8, KJV. Regardless of our reasons for running from God, He still has a purpose for our lives. Sometimes God prepares us to accomplish the ministry at hand, and there are times when God wants to test us, to see how we will handle what He has given us. God will test our faith when we are running from the blessings God has stored in the storehouse just for us. What is your calling? What is your family's calling, and how does it connect to the master plan that God has strategically designed for you and even your extended family? Are we carrying out God's purposes for your lives? Are you afraid of what others say? Or are we being disobedient to God? I was frightened to step into ministry, even though I knew that God had been using my family when I was very young. Even though I was frightened, God knew that I was an introvert and suddenly unveiled the cover from my eyes. My siblings and I felt the enormous move of God instantaneously and simultaneously, so we began praying with each other often. Even though we believe God at His word, we wanted to see a sign, to know that it is really God. God showed Thomas proof that it was Jesus who rose from the dead. My family did not see the nail marks in Jesus' hands, as Thomas did after Jesus was resurrected from the dead, and we did not see where the nails were in His side. We were not there when the stones were rolled away. But we believe that Jesus Christ died for the sins of the entire world. God spoke to my family, just as He spoke to Moses in the Old Testament, in the Pentateuch, in the book of Exodus. God gave the law to Moses, how they built the special holy tent, tabernacle, the rules of worship. Moses was the main person who recorded the events. In the book of Exodus, Moses wrote down everything the Lord said, just as God instructed me to do as I rewrote.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.